Light is why you're looking at me and everything around me right now. Let us study this everyday phenomenon in more detail. Light is said to have wave and particle natures at the same time. Seems confusing? Here, particle refers to incredibly small fundamental blocks of energy called photons. By small, I mean really small. As per our current understanding of physics, these photons have very negligible or no mass at all. They don't even require any medium to travel. Now that we know about the particle nature, at least the basics of it, let us grasp some knowledge on why light is also a wave. To understand this, we need to look at the double slit experiment carried out by Thomas Young in 1803. He took a photographic plate which forms patterns on exposure to light. Young placed this plate behind an opaque board with two holes on it, or slits as he said. First, he beamed light through one slit only. He found the plate had a faded pattern. Okay, does that mean light is a longitudinal wave? When we beamed light with both of the slits opened, we found this on the plate. So, why do we see this discontinuity in the pattern? If we take our first case and use its conclusion as a base, we will find that the two waves from the two slits interfered to form this pattern. So, does that mean light is a transverse wave? For the last case, Young took the source of light far away from the arrangement and lowered the intensity of the light rays way more than two of the previous cases. As he beamed the light towards the arrangement this time around, there was nothing on the photographic plate. So he thought to leave it as it is for the whole night. As Young came back the next morning, he saw two tiny spots on the plate. Which means if these are not waves which got diverted from their path, they need to be particles. And as these particles that we call photons are said to have no mass, yet they have some momentum to hit the plate and form patterns on it, as per special theory of relativity by Albert Einstein, these photons must be traveling at the speed limit of present-day physics, in other words, the speed of light. Now you know that light is a wave of photons that travel 300 million meters every second.